Hello, and welcome to this video series on the SPT Framework. In this series of videos, we're going to cover off what the SPT Framework is, how it operates, and we're going to cover off some of the background themes that are informing its development and how you actually use it. This particular video is going to cover off the framework itself. So what is a framework and what does that mean for us as automation software developers? So the development of software typically requires tools. The days of simply bashing out code or your boilerplate code in your development environment from scratch and every single machine are gone. Even if you simply just reuse code over and over again from previous machines, that is a form of tool in the form of a library. There are other tools that have been developed that exist out in the software development space, mostly in the IT development world, but those can be adopted into our automation world. And taking these proven technologies, disciplines and practices into our world allows us to be better automation engineers. When you're building a machine in the first instance, you go through a design phase of your project. You look at how you're going to actually structure your code to achieve what you want to achieve. And in that design phase, consideration or the tools such as object-oriented programming, UML integration, and frameworks come to the fore. Once you're actually programming the code itself, then your standard programming conventions, whether you use Hungarian notation, how you choose to name variables, how you choose to run state machines, etc., all of that is then comes into effect, along with your source code management, how you manage changes and how you manage your code so that your team is working on the same code base the entire time. And once the code has actually then been finished and completed, you run it through static analysis tools to make sure it obeys the your company's conventions. You can run it through profilers to see if you've actually achieved the most efficient version of that program. And there's also automated testing under the test-driven development paradigm. The particular one we're going to cover off in this video, obviously, is frameworks. And frameworks are there as a tool to increase your software quality. So a framework is exactly what you think it is if you were building a house, right? It is a foundational base of implementation. Okay, it provides a structure that everyone using that framework agrees to build with. Okay, so it can provide you a core set of library components at the base level. For like your axes, your buzzers, your buttons, etc. But it also provides the structure of how you assemble those components together to create your overall machine code. The frameworks are extensible. So you take the framework as it exists, as it's deployed, given to you, and you then override parts of it to implement your specialized functionality to do your particular objective. And one thing to note as well, which some people struggle with frameworks, is that inversion of control. So the overall program's flow, generally speaking, is no longer controlled by yourself, but by the framework itself. And you are just plugging in your code to make it do what you want to do in the end. The benefit of this, obviously, removes your need for boilerplate code, which reduces your programming time and reduces errors at that level. Frameworks are generally maintained by a group of people, so they are tested repeatedly on different projects and have then been formed over time, which gives you a lot of confidence in using them. And they effectively allow you to organize and structure your code to allow you to write more clean and secure code. They generally speaking simplify your testing and your debugging because they organize your code in a standardized structure, which means you always know where to go look for particular things. Just knowing the type of thing you're after will inform where in the framework you look for it. You avoid duplicated code. It makes it more adaptable, so components in a framework will be interchangeable, and you're able to focus more instead of writing the boilerplate, but on writing the specific bits that your project needs to actually come into life. And again, the main benefit of it is they can be extended, so you can take it and make it your own. Okay, so let's look at what that means for the SPT framework. So the SPT framework gives you a framework for identifying your general function blocks. It uses a modular design for its programming, and we separate up the machine you're going to create into essentially three component parts. We have a single main machine block, which handles your high level programming, your state machine for the high level machine, so the whole system, things like HMI interfaces, that sort of stuff. And then we have equipment modules that sit below that. They handle the local machine sections, so anything needs to operate independently. And below that, we then have our components, which again are your axes, buzzers, buttons, etc., etc. So let's take this very simple illustration of a machine with multiple different sections. We have a transport overall for the entire system, forming station, filling station, sealing, weighing, packaging, and palletizing. Now we can break that up using the SPT framework into a load of constituent parts. The first bit is going to be our machine part, which is then covers the entire machine put together. So that's our general state machine for the entire thing, our HMI interface, for example, so you can run operate the entire machine, and then relevant information that needs to be passed up from the individual substations, which are formed of our equipment modules. In this case, the transport section, forming station, filling station, etc., etc. And one of the main benefits of the SPT framework is the existence of components. So whilst we structure using the framework into the machine, equipment modules to have separate state machines for the sub-elements of a machine, we then have components below that which are pre-done boilerplate code, which you can use directly without having to write your own. So there'll be code for an axis, there'll be code for buttons, for example, for IO elements that you can just bring into your equipment modules and deploy. And if you need to extend them, the operation of them in any way, then you can do that as part of the framework. So all your job then becomes is to design your code around the framework to fit your machine, and then insert the code into the relevant areas of those three blocks, whether it's at the machine level, the equipment module, or the component, to facilitate what you're actually trying to achieve. And then you end up with a very clean structure of your code. So we have our main machine, our equipment modules, and our components. So when you're trying to debug, or when you're trying to extend functionality, you can go to exactly where you know the code you need to modify will be, because it's very clearly defined, both in terms of a library of base blocks or our components, and in a hierarchy of structure, which is the framework itself. Okay, thank you for listening. This has been a training video on the SPT framework, going over what a framework actually is and giving a broad overview of what the SPT framework does and how it breaks things down into its constituent parts. Thank you.